Hello, I'm Brian Hengesbaugh, partner with Baker and McKenzie in Chicago and chair of global privacy and security within the IP Tech Group. I'm here to talk for a few minutes today about the Cybersecurity Imperative report that's coming out. This is a wonderfully important report. If you're worried about who's out there that might be attacking my company, how are they attacking the company? What is it that they're after? What is it that I can do to protect myself? Then this is a report that you have to look at. I'm here to talk for a few minutes about the legal and regulatory implications of the report and what it's finding. As you look closely at the report, there's several layers to it, but one aspect of it is talking about new technologies and how they're emerging, whether it's blockchain or AI or machine-to-machine learning or Internet of Things or other technology developments, really creating opportunities in the data space for companies. And that's increasing the surface area for attack for these types of threats. And what are the threats? Well, there's certainly cyber criminals that feature prominently and are getting better at what they're doing. There's recreational hackers. If you ever go to the DEF CON conference in Las Vegas, you'll see 15,000 hackers teaching each other how to hack better and more tattoos and piercings than you've ever seen in your life. And then certainly there's the nation states, which in some respects are the most deadly of the threats because of the resources that a nation state brings to it. So in this context of more data, more threats, I'd like to talk for a couple minutes about regulations and legal requirements and implications of these things. Two big buckets of regulations we'd like to focus on. The first are privacy breach notification requirements, and then the second bucket would be public company obligations. So within the privacy notice obligations, just a sampling of some of the developments around the world. First, we have Europe. The General Data Protection Regulation has a requirement to notify a personal data breach within 72 hours of becoming aware of it. Broad scope of application to personal data, very fast timing requirement, very difficult to manage. Secondly, the great nation of California has come out with the California Privacy Act, which has, among other provisions, it has a requirement or an ability for consumer class action to go after $750 per consumer per incident of damages associated with a data security incident where the company didn't have reasonable security. So that overcomes what has historically been a challenge for plaintiffs, which is proving damages. This is statutory penalties right out of the box. So something that's going to be very attractive for consumers. And then thirdly, if you keep going around the globe, you've got China even coming out now with its Cybersecurity Act. And embedded within that, there's many aspects of the California law or the China requirements, but within that is a breach notification duty to users and to authorities. So a lot of emerging requirements. The regulators are largely unregulated. They can do what they want in this space in terms of setting obligations for companies and really putting pressure on companies when an incident actually arises. So I want to have three takeaways for you for this. First takeaway is documentation. It's great that the company would follow the NIST standard or ISO or another type of standard. It's critical that you document it because in the aftermath of an incident, you're going to have to prove that the company had reasonable and appropriate security. So good documentation is critical. Second point is tabletops. You have to do some drills where you get the relevant people in the room, that's legal, that's security, that's business leads, that's functional leads, that's communications, to really go through scenarios in different geographies too, Europe, the US, Asia Pac, et cetera, where you have a chance to walk through the incident, figure out, have some discussions about how you're gonna actually handle it. You wanna do that well before the actual incident arises. And then third, we want you to take a look at and have a fresh look at how you're balancing cybersecurity risk against business opportunity. Absolutely the case, we're in the digital age. Data is king, data is critical for business, but make sure that you're really embedding cybersecurity in all aspects of the design and launch and consideration of your product and service and how you're going about things. That will serve you very well in the long run. So thanks for listening and enjoy the report.